Good afternoon, and a rather somewhat damp, dreary day so far, as was forecast. Yeah, it kind of sucks out there a little bit. I know I just went to check the mail a little while ago. Yes, didn't get up till quarter after 12. It's like, oh boy, I must have needed the sleep. Yeah, I must have needed the sleep, alright. Yeah, I'd get up every once or twice or three times just to go use the bathroom in the middle of the night. It's like, and then the butler says, okay, now you can sleep. So, yeah. Back to work for the next 4 days starting tomorrow. Working that many days in a row is just gonna get used to it. It's like, yeah, the older you get, the more you feel getting up early. It's like, really? And I think I turn 50 next year. Cue the theme to Hawaii 5-0. Nah, I'm not gonna do that. Copyright. And I think a week from tomorrow is the end of the month already. Yeah, the end of the month is a week from tomorrow. Summer's almost over. Yeah, summer's almost over. We've hit the dog days of summer now. Now come Labor Day weekend. It's where the CFL season really starts. Beginning with there with the Labor Day weekend games, a stretch drive for the playoff spot, the Grey Cup begins there. And also the Pennant Drive, which started that weekend. Actually, yeah, it would literally start that weekend. Beginning of September is on a Friday. So take that how you will. Cool time, right? Sure. Books for younger readers for $600. Answer. She wrote the classics Ramona La Peste and Beezus and Ramona. Question. Who is Beverly Cleary? Yeah, you got me. Yeah, I'm a little slow. It's like too much thinking. Think too much. Yeah, look what happened to my hair. There isn't any. Or very little. Books for younger readers for 1,000. This will end the Jeopardy round. Answer. This kid lit classic has a chapter called The Puppies Arrive. No idea. You could ask me that again later. Nothing. Now, so with that being Wednesday, there's probably a few day baseball games. Couldn't think of any more comic strips. I may have exhausted half of them. Although, no, this is with books. Or go with the Tom Swift. When I was a kid, going up with Tom Swift Jr. or the Hardy Boys. Now it's like, give me some Stuart McLean or any of his Vinyl Cafe books or CD packs. Yeah, I'm good. I'm sorry, a storyteller has gone way too soon, even though he was 68, even though it was in 2017. It was a sad day when he passed away. Of course, I have a book of Anthony Bourdain in here that I haven't quite read through yet. I really need to start reading that up. Yeah, obviously, he wrote it before he died. Or committed suicide, but still, I was like, what the heck? I don't know why actually Bourdain's death bothered me more, but it happens. So which celebrity death bothered you? Which book did you like reading? Which comic strips did you like reading? Oh wait, I've asked those ones. Which book now can't you put down? I remember reading one of Stephen King's books, The Dead Zone. That was a good book. Of course, Stephen King was a pretty good author himself. My mom liked reading his books. Can't remember all of what she had, but I think she had quite a number of them. So, yeah. I wanted to make another video last night, and I ended up getting lazy and not doing it, because old age means, like, no, I want sleep. So, yeah, so, who knows what I'll do today. I'm getting awfully close to 600 videos. I am getting quite close to 600 videos. I'm very close. This video here will be 598. So, yeah. Did I mention yesterday I can't wait for hockey? Well, I can't wait for hockey. Prince Albert Raiders. Yeah, I mentioned this yesterday. Prince Albert Raiders. Single game tickets apparently don't go on sale until September 6th. I need some fucking hockey. I need some hockey. Yes, I did mention this yesterday. Short memory. Very short memory. Time for an NHL game soon. Last one I went to was 2019 in Edmonton. Edmonton beat Buffalo that night 7-2. Okay. Yeah, so, yeah, it's pretty bad when I need hockey. I need to go to a game. Bad. Yeah, right when the Raiders' regular season starts, it's right when the NHL should be into its regular season, preseason games. Of course, once I see the hockey news yearbook, I'm grabbing it. Yes, it's must have because it's got the full schedule. So apparently there's an idea that somebody threw out that the NHL's gonna have a little slightly have a they were has a 16 game schedule and start times will range anywhere between 6 and 9 o'clock. Oh, yeah, that's gonna be like rough. No, rougher than that, yeah. And when the time change happens and the 8 o'clock big games become 9 o'clock games here in Saskatchewan, it's like gonna be like, I don't like that. Because I have to stay up later than I want to. And then an hour is big. Yes. Yes. Well, I'll find one at some point. I better stop now because I'm going to be out here and go meet up with the dietitian today. Yeah, it's on my calendar, so. Yeah, meet up with the dietitian. Do some catching up. Yeah, on that note, in the meantime, and in between time, stay tuned for the next one.